subscribe to Nykaa TV and press the bell icon to make sure you never miss an update from us.
If you're tired after a long exhausting day and you just want to hit the hay, remember your skin repairs 10 times quicker at night, and the right nighttime skin routine will even aid it further. Hi guys, my name is Shreya Jain and today I'm going to teach you how you can build your nighttime skincare routine from scratch. The first product you need is a makeup remover. There are different types and textures of makeup removers available in the market depending on your preference. There are oils, balms and even liquid makeup removers. You can also go for micellar waters if you are not a huge makeup lover and you just wear very light makeup. I'm going to be using the Innisfree Cleansing Oil. This is great to break down any makeup. You could have the most long-lasting liquid lipstick on and this will break it down like that. So just take a couple of pumps of this on your fingers and just massage it between your fingers to ensure that it's nice and warm, and then start massaging it on your face. Now this will break down any makeup that you have on your face. Always ensure that if you are wearing any sort of makeup that you remove it before you sleep, because it will clog your pores and that's going to lead to pimples and skin issues, which I'm sure you don't want. And once you're done with the good old massaging technique, take a napkin which is slightly damp and just wipe everything off. You see, all of that is what you don't want on your face throughout the night. Once you're done with removing your makeup, next in comes the face wash. A face wash is an essential part of your nighttime skincare routine as it will clean out your pores and your pores can breathe again. Essentially, you should use a deep cleansing face wash at nighttime, which is different from the one you use in the morning, but you can also use a moisturizing face wash if your face is really dry. I'm going to be using the Neutrogena Deep Clean Foaming Cleanser because it really ensures all of the makeup is out of your pores and your skin is spick and clean. Start off with slightly damp or wet face so that your face wash can activate quicker. So just take a little bit of this face wash on your fingers and all you want to do is massage it in and then onto your face. Make sure all of the nooks and crannies, like the corners of your nose as well as the inner corners of your eyes, are covered, because that's where the makeup stays even after removing it with a makeup wipe. And once you're done with massaging your face with the face wash, just splash a little bit of cool water and wipe everything away. Try using cool water because it really calms your skin down. After a face wash, go in with an exfoliator. Exfoliator is great for your skin at night time because it will get rid of any dead skin cells and will ensure that new skin can come up quickly and your face looks rejuvenated and fresh. There are different types of bases of scrubs available in the market. There's a gel-based scrub, a cream-based scrub, as well as a water-based scrub. But what you really need to check is that the exfoliating beads themselves are natural and not chemical or synthetic based, because that will really help your skin out. I'm going to be using the Claire's Coffee and Black Sugar Facial Polish, not only because I'm addicted to coffee, but also because coffee is really great for your skin. It rejuvenates your skin and makes it brighter as well, and it will help your skin repair throughout the night as well. Now this just smells heavenly. Like, for all coffee lovers out there, just buy it already because it's so good. But anyway, the correct way of using a scrub is taking a little bit of it. You don't need a lot. Just warm it up between your fingers and then go on your face. Just do not scrub around your eye area because your eye area is pretty delicate. Try staying in your T-zone more because that's the area where you get most amount of blackheads as well as dead skin cells. Go in circular motions, which are very gentle. You don't want to be harsh on your face because it will only damage your skin more. If you have dry skin type, ensure that your scrub has a more moisturizing base, and if you have more oily skin, a gel-based scrub is going to be the best one for you. I am, of course, using a scrub that has a very nice moisturizing base to it. Just moisten your face a little and gently wipe everything away. You would love how soft your skin feels after this step, and you'll thank me for it as well. An optional step that I have for you, which you can do every alternate night, is masking up. Masks are great for your skin and there are a variety of masks available in the market. Mattifying mask, glow mask, nourishing mask, and also glitter masks, which are really fun. The particular one I want to show you guys is the O3 Plus Dermal Sulfur Cooling Mask. This is great to just calm down any inflammation that you might have going on, or it's great only to use as a cooling mask as well. It makes sure you get a nice glow on your skin, and it's pretty universal actually. Any skin type can use this. So if you've applied the mask or you just scrubbed your face, the next step has to be a toner, just to ensure that all of your pores are shut down. A toner really helps in ensuring that all of the gunk stays out of your pores and your pores are clean and they don't clog up quickly. There are a variety of toners available in the market meant for different types of skin. For oily skin, you can go for toners which are supposed to mattify your skin down. For dry skin, you can go with the toner which is supposed to give you glow and add in some moisture, or you can even use good old rose water to tone your skin. I'm going to be using the Kaya Purifying Toner. This is great for people who also have acne prone skin, and currently I was having a couple of breakouts, so this is just great for that. It also has a spray nozzle, so you don't really need to use a cotton pad. You can just literally spritz this on your face. It's as easy as 1, 2, 3. You need to follow up your toner with the serum to ensure that your skin stays healthy and looks healthy. Serums pack your skin with nice vitamins and minerals so that your skin can rejuvenate quickly. Especially at nighttime, serums are a must because they help repair your skin so beautifully. There are different types of serums available for different skin issues like anti-aging, pigmentation, as well as just normal moisturization and glow. There are some serums which are only supposed to be used at night because you cannot go out in the sun after using them, like retinol. But I'm going to be using today the White Seed Serum by The Face Shop, which is a beautiful serum for dry as well as combination skin, as it balances your skin down and ensures that it looks and feels beautiful. So just take a couple of pumps, I'd say about 2 to 3 of this on your fingers. You don't need a lot. Just warm it up between your fingers and pat it down into your skin so that it can directly get absorbed into the skin. This will impart a beautiful glow, also calm down your skin so there's no inflammation going on your skin. Give your serum about 2 to 3 minutes to get properly absorbed into the skin before going on to the next step. The next step in your nighttime skincare routine should be an eye cream. An eye cream is such a big essential because your under eyes are the first place where you start seeing aging, and you really don't want those wrinkles before time, right? So eye creams again come in different varieties which you can use for your eye type, but generally a high moisturization as well as high collagen level eye cream is what I would recommend, as it really ensures that your eyes stay hydrated throughout the night. I'm going to be using the Collagen Eye Cream by It's Skin. This has high collagen content and it also ensures that your under eyes don't dry out throughout the night, especially when we are having AC environments, because AC dries up our skin very quickly. You want to take a little bit of this eye cream, literally a pea-sized amount on your finger, like literally just that much. You don't need a lot of eye cream. On your ring finger, because your ring finger is the most gentlest finger and your under eyes really are very sensitive. Just massage it in between your ring fingers and then just pat it under your eyes like that. Go over your eyes as well, because you have like dark circles and not just dark under eyes. So just go all over your eye area. You can also give your skin a little bit of massage at this point to increase the blood flow in your skin so that your skin looks more healthy. The last step in your night skincare routine has to be a night cream. Why specifically a night cream? Because they're formulated in such a way that it helps repair your skin over a period of time throughout the night. Night creams are available for different set of skin issues like anti-aging, anti-pollution, as well as just normal glow and moisturization. I have two options for you guys, both of which I love. The first one is this Innisfree Sleeping Pack. This is just like sleeping pack. The name says it all. It's like a face mask, like a night cream. So you're supposed to apply this all over your face and it helps your skin look beautiful, so when you wake up looking really nice and radiant. But today I'm going to be using the Kama Ayurveda Rejuvenating and Brightening Night Cream. Why I love this is because when you wake up with brighter looking skin, so you also like tend to wear lesser makeup because your skin already looks so beautiful. This is also Ayurvedic, so it has a lot of goodness of nature packed in here as well. I'll have to add, it's not the best fragrance, but it's so good for your skin. So just take a little bit of it. Again, you don't need a lot. Just a little bit of this cream, massage it in between your fingers and then pat it into your skin. This deeply moisturizes your skin and it's just so good for nighttime, as your skin would love what you're doing to it. The texture is super creamy but absorbable. It's not heavy or greasy at all. While you're doing all of this, make sure you go down your neck as well, because your neck deserves all of the love too. And that's it. Your basic nighttime skincare routine is done. Now all you have to do is fill in all of these categories with products that you love for your skin. I'm just going to give you the categories once again so you can note it down right now. Start off with the makeup remover and follow it up with the face wash to ensure that your skin is super clean. Then exfoliators are a must to just let go of the dead skin cells, and then go on with the toner. You can in between just add in a mask if you prefer. After the toner, just follow up with the serum that your skin has all of the important vitamins and nutrients that it needs, and then apply an eye cream to your under eyes to make sure your eyes are hydrated and moisturized. And lastly, finish off with a nice night cream to make sure that you wake up to beautiful looking skin. I hope this video was helpful for you guys in building your nighttime skincare routine. I would love to know what products you use for your nighttime skincare routine. So comment below and let me know. So that is it. But we also have a giveaway for you guys, and there are going to be two winners for this giveaway. All of the rules will be mentioned down in the description box. So make sure you check them out and do participate in the giveaway. For more such helpful videos, don't forget to subscribe to Nykaa TV and like and share this video. I will see you guys super soon. Till then, take care. Bye. We'll be right back.